Father God, I pray that you would be upon us as we have our kids help study today. Lord, I also pray that you would help us understand each other's takes, Lord. And I pray that you continue to be upon us as we continue to read these daily readings posts, Lord. And I also pray that you would be with us as we are either doing our praise reports while we're doing worship, and Lord, while we are sharing our takes. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Amen. So does anyone have any praise reports or anything they want to share that they're thankful for this week?
My life.
Amen. I can share. So this week is my last week of my college classes, and I'm just thankful because everyone who I told that I was going to sign up for this class said that I wasn't going to be able to do it or, like, keep up with the pace of it because it's a hard class. But I'm just thankful because I managed to, like, keep a B average, and hopefully all my assignments might come back and give me an A. But I'm just thankful that I at least have a B, and that is my last week, because even though people told me that it was going to be hard, I still was able to do it and maintain a good grade.
Well, I thank God for my birthday. So I really just want to thank him for another year of life, and just for his goodness that he has shown me throughout these 21 years. So I just want to continue to thank God for that.
Man. Anyone else?
I'm thankful for God for Saturday, because on Saturday we went to the farm to pick some vegetables, and we also went to the beach.
Man. Ian, do you have one?
My praise report is also at Saturday we went to the beach.
Man. So we could do our worship if no one else has.
I don't know how to say exactly how I feel, and I can't begin to tell you what your love has meant. I'm lost for words. Is there a way to show the passion in my heart? Can I express how truly great I think you are, my dearest friend? I don't know how to say exactly how I feel. I can't begin to tell you what your love has meant. I'm lost for words. Is there a show the passion in my heart? Can I express how truly great I think you are, my dearest friend? Lord, this is my desire, mine on you till every drop is gone. I'll pour my love like oil upon your feet, like pour my love on you. If praise is like perfume, I'll lavish mine on you till every drop is gone. I'll pour my love on you. How I feel, I can't begin to tell you what your love has meant, and I'm lost for words. And is there a way to show the passion in my heart? Can
So today we'll just share two takes from the last 4 days, and I can go first. In Isaiah 9 verse 4 to 5, it says, "For you will break the yoke of their slavery and lift the heavy burden from their shoulders. You will break the oppressor's rod, just as you did when you destroyed the army in Midian. The boots of the warrior and the uniforms bloodstained by war will all be burned. They will be fuel for the fire." And I was just meditating on this verse today because in this verse it mentions, you know, two main things that I saw. And the two main aspects that I saw in this verse was freedom and fuel for the fire. And what I, you know, what I received from God was that the fuel for the fire was basically his body being fuel for us, providing us strength, providing us, you know, the comfort, providing us, you know, our answered prayers to just keep on going with life, to keep on being able to have this ability to praise him, to keep on being able to do all of these things for him. And what comes with all of these things, especially following his life, is having the freedom to you know, just live our lives, the freedom to just be free from the punishments that you know, we were given because of our sin. So anyone want to go next?
I could go. So mine is Hebrews 6, verse 18, which says, "So God has given both his promise and his oath. These two things are unchangeable because it is impossible for God to lie. Therefore, we have fled to him for refuge and can have great confidence as we hold to the hope that he lies before us." And this verse tells us that God doesn't lie. His promises are and oaths are reliable. There are many reliable promises, and one of them is God saying that he will give a child to Abraham and Sarah. They didn't believe it because they were old, but then they had a son named Isaac. This shows that God will always keep his promises because he's truthful. God will always fulfill our prayers when we put our faith in him and obey him. But it is only if it's God's will and timing.
Amen.
I can go next. Mine's on Hebrews 7. What I got from Hebrews 7 is verse 19. It says, "For law never made anything perfect, but now we have confidence in a better hope through which we draw near to God." This verse shows me that the law never made anything perfect. Even though we still follow the law, it doesn't mean that we are perfect, especially in our relationship with God. Even though our relationship with God isn't perfect, we should still continue to love and have faith in him. We need to continue to have confidence in a better hope. We need to continue to want God, that we want to be closer and closer to God. Even though we aren't perfect, God is. Nothing in our lives are perfect, but we should keep going for God. Keep doing these things for God. Because if we aren't doing it for God, who are we doing it for?
I can go next. Hebrews 6. What I got from Hebrews 6 is that it says here, "So we must go on from the first lessons that we learned about Christ. We must grow as believers so that we understand more and more. We should not go back to those first lessons again and again. We already know that we must turn away from wrong things that led to death. We know that we must trust God." Hebrews 6, verse 1. What I got from this verse is that we must always trust God. Like if he tells us to put your favorite thing in the fire, we have to trust him. And what I also got from this verse is that every day we learn something new because each chapter makes you learn more about God.
Amen. In Isaiah 8, verse 15 to 17, it says, "Many will stumble and fall, never to rise again. They will be snared and captured. Preserve the teaching of God. Entrust his instruction to those who follow me. I will wait for the Lord, for those who turned away from the descendants of Jacob. I will put my hope in him." And in this verse, it just keeps talking about basically preserving your relationship with God by investing your time in him, by investing your resources on him, because it says that many will stumble and fall, meaning many will go the wrong way, many will fail, many will, you know, keep on sinning. But if we preserve the teachings of God, if we increase our relationship with him, we are constantly given the strength and we are constantly given the protection to fight our battles properly with God beside us.
Psalm 73, verse 26. My health may fail and my spirit may grow weak, but God remains the strength of my heart. He is mine forever. This verse shows me that even when we are failing spiritually or physically, we will continue to have faith in God, because when we have this faith in God, we will know that he will continue to give us everything that we need, whether it's spiritually or physically or even in our hands. And this really shows from my take from last time from God's promises, and God will God said that he will never leave us nor forsake us. And when we continue to have this faith in him, we will continue to really know more of his promises and really have faith in them, because we already know that all of these other promises are real. And yeah.
I can go next. Hebrews 7. What I got from Hebrews 7 is that it says here, we know that our Lord came from Judah's tribe. Moses never said that priests could come from Judah's tribe. So we see that the law has, old law has changed. Hebrews 7, verse 14. What I got from this verse is that Jesus may came from Judah's tribe, but other priests didn't.
So, mine's going to be on Hebrews 8. It says, in Hebrews 8, verse 11 and 12, it says, and they will not need to teach their neighbors, nor will they need to teach their relatives, saying, you should know the Lord, for everyone, from the least to the greatest, will know me already. Now forgive their wickedness, and I will never again remember their sins. These verses show me that when that day comes, everyone will know God, and God will forgive everyone and forget their sins. When Jesus returns, everyone should know the Lord. Whether they're young or old, whether they're your family or not, every nation will know God. As more and more people continue to know God, the more closer Jesus is going to return, and that day will come. When Jesus returns, the Lord will also forgive us for all the wicked things we have done in our lives. Even though he will forgive us of our sins, when he returns, we still shouldn't sin.
Amen. So does anyone want to add anything, or, you know?
Yeah, I can add something. I wanted to add on what my sister said in Psalm 73, verse 26. I'll just read it for us again. My flesh and my heart fail, but God is the strength of my heart and my portion forever. And whenever I come back to this verse, whenever I read this verse again, it just continues to remind me that everything that we store up here in the world, you know, will not last forever. It said there, right? My flesh and my heart fail, but God is the strength of my heart and my portion forever. And so even though it is talking about, you know, how our well-being will be, even though we are weak, you know, God is strong. So it gives us a glimpse as to even like our personal possessions, right? If we continue to cling onto the physical things of this world, whether it be our job, our school, our money, or even our own family, and we kind of move God aside, then we will fail, we will perish. But as we continue to cling on and hold on to God's promises, you know, then that's when we gain strength. That's when we are confident in how we live our lives, right? Just like what Amiya shared earlier, that in everything that we do, it should be for God. Because if it isn't for God, then who is it for, right? And so as we continue to live our lives, as we continue to grow in the faith and grow even in our relationship with God, let us just continue to remember that, yes, the things of this world are nice, you know. God gave us these things. God gave us our home, our job, our family, our education. But the main thing that he doesn't want us to do is to put all of these other things above him. And so let's just continue to prioritize him. Let's just continue to put him first, because it is through those things that it says here, God is the strength of my heart, that he will strengthen us and he will provide all that we need. You know that verse that we always say, you know, even me and my family, we say it a lot in Matthew 6:33, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, then all of these things shall be added unto you, right? And so let's just continue to seek God first. Let's just continue to prioritize him first. And let us continue to store riches in heaven. Let's continue to store our treasures in heaven, because it is those things that will last forever and not the things in this world. And so I know you guys are young. I'm growing old now, but you guys are young. And so you guys are very privileged and very, and I'm grateful that you guys already know the Lord at such a young age. And so just continue to run with that. Just continue to grow in that. And yeah, just allow the Holy Spirit to continue to lead you and guide you in your lives. And so that's just what I wanted to share.
Amen. So we can close in prayer. Ian, can you close us in prayer, please?
Jesus, thank you for letting us have this Bible study. And thank you for, like, sharing, letting us share all these takes. And thank you for gathering us here. In Jesus' name, amen.